So Makerspace is really a place where faculty, staff, and students come together and create objects, you know, where they come and collaborate, where they can come in, brainstorm, and you know, maybe create a prototype. 3 or 4 years ago, I had the opportunity of reading an article at the EDUCAUSE magazine, and the entire article was devoted to Makerspace. It was something that was new to me. I thought that this was something that UMass Boston could definitely use. You know, I was fortunate to work with or meet Helen Mary, and we were able to find the space to roll out the Makerspace lab.
3D printing itself is a collaborative process, but then to build the lab by getting support and help from other entities and agencies that were doing this elsewhere, we were able to speed up the process. When we first started this, APIRVA offered out to me the opportunity to go to a 3D conference. And at that point, I met Ian Roy from Brandeis, who was running a 3D lab at Brandeis, and theirs was well on its way. And he has just been amazingly helpful to us with information and support. And we've had a lot of help from the engineering department here too, Dr. Philip Chukov. He's been very helpful in his engineering students with offering support and advice on what we should do next and, you know, what equipment is important, and lending support and expertise.
When you walk into the room and see all the things that have been made in this room, itself is very impressive. What could be better for a class of students who are supposed to be inspired by me? I brought them here to make a organ, any organ of their choice. So who helped us? John Mozzarella and Mish McIntyre, both of them were on board to train the students and help them to execute this work.
At the Makerspace, we offer faculty one-on-one consults to see how we could help the faculty pedagogically match the Makerspace to their own curriculum in their course. And so we do that a couple of ways. One of those ways is we have resources already available through a website called Thingiverse, a open source 3D library of objects that are ready to print. So if there's not enough time to devote in the class for having them to design something themselves, we do have this library ready to go. We also have the NIH library available for sciences, chemistry, molecules. There's quite a bit of 3D files ready to print that are already been tested and ready to go. The second way we work with faculty is through when they want their students to really have a hands-on experience themselves that will give them a real way to apply directly to the Makerspace a creation process or design process, which includes system thinking, design thinking, trial and error, acceptance of failure, persistence. All those things can happen in the Makerspace, and we can help you design a very intricate or a very simple interaction assignment or project development for your students.
I started trying to make a liver. Going to the workshop, made a bit, and all the people who were there to help you out and teach you along the way definitely helped, making the experience a lot smoother and pretty enriching. It was a really interesting experience that in the program was on a tablet, and it made it very intuitive to kind of play around with it and create it. I would say it was pretty engaging. It kept, like, it was very into it. You had to focus on it and really kind of put yourself forward to try to make it work. It was definitely a positive experience, and I would recommend it to anyone who has the ability to access it.